Josiah Bartlett was a man of varied interests and talents. During his 40 years of adult life, he commanded provincial troops, was a representative to the Continental Congress, experimented in medicine, was a successful doctor, fathered 12 children, served as associate and as Chief Justice of the New Hampshire Superior Court, was governor of the state, and founded the New Hampshire Medical Society. Although he had little formal training, Josiah Bartlett became a learned, educated man and an excellent doctor. Bartlett learned reading, writing, and mathematics in school, and studied Greek and Latin on his own. At age 16, Josiah Bartlett became a doctor and went to study with a relative who was a practicing physician. In 1750, after 5 years of interning, Bartlett opened his own practice in Kingston, New Hampshire. Josiah Bartlett's experimenting and innovating in medicine not only cured many patients, but also extended his own life when endangered by a high fever. His doctor ordered him to bed with no open windows or liquids allowed. Bartlett persuaded some friends to go against the doctor's orders and to bring him a jug of cider, which he sipped through the night. The cider allowed him to sweat, and by morning, the fever was broken. His fever cure was the first in a long career of new techniques and procedures that Josiah Bartlett pioneered. Many people in the colony suffered with severe sore throats. Bartlett discovered a cure that used Peruvian bark. Years later, quinine was extracted from the same bark. And it is now realized that quinine was the ingredient that cured the sore throats. In 1725, Josiah married his cousin, Mary Bartlett, and started a family. Three of their 12 children became doctors and produced 7 grandsons, who were also doctors. The whole Bartlett family lived and practiced medicine in New Hampshire. Josiah Bartlett was an early patriot, working hard to further the revolution. Because Bartlett was very popular among the people of New Hampshire, he was elected to the provincial assembly. Once his patriotism was recognized by the royal governor, Bartlett was dismissed from the provincial assembly in 1774. The people of New Hampshire then elected Bartlett to the first provincial Congress. When the first Continental Congress was called, Bartlett was elected by the provincial Congress to go to Philadelphia. He was unable to attend because his home had been completely destroyed by fire. Although the fire was probably set by Tories who opposed independence, Bartlett was strong in his convictions. He rebuilt his new house on the same location. While Bartlett was in the Continental Congress, he also commanded a regiment of provincial troops. The Continental Congress had a custom of commencing with the most northern colony on any vote. Because Dr. Bartlett was from New Hampshire, he was the first called to vote on the Declaration of Independence. Firmly believing in the justice of the cause, he raised his head upward and said, "Yea and amen." Bartlett was also the first person to sign the Declaration of Independence after John Hancock, President of the Congress. In a letter that he wrote on July 22, 1776, soon after the Declaration was signed, Bartlett said, "Lord Howe's proclamation has now convinced everybody that no offers are to be made us, but absolute submission. I think it very happy for America that Britain has insisted on those terms. For had she proposed a treaty and offered some concessions, there would have been danger of divisions, or at least of our not acting with unanimity and spirit, as I think will now be the case." Even after the dramatic signing of the Declaration, an act of treason against the government of England, the signers and founders of the Revolution were still uneasy about the local support they received. Although at times service to country and service to family were in conflict, Bartlett usually served the new country. He did refuse to serve in Congress twice. First, he had to rebuild his home, and second, in 1777, he had to settle his affairs at home and rest from the long hours of work and travel from Philadelphia to New Hampshire. In a letter on September 10, 1776, he wrote to a friend, "You'll excuse me, as I'm hardly able to write." Having rested a year, Bartlett returned to the Continental Congress in 1778. and became the first to vote for the Articles of Confederation and Perpetual Union. In 1778, Josiah Bartlett declined the national senatorship and retired to state politics. Bartlett became an associate justice of the Superior Court of New Hampshire in 1782. Like many men of his time, Bartlett had no formal training as a lawyer. This practice prompted several of the ablest attorneys to express the opinion that justice had never been better administered than when the judges knew very little law. In 1788, Bartlett became Chief Justice of the Superior Court. A year later, Bartlett was elected to the New Hampshire Senate, and in 1790 became the President of New Hampshire. His title was changed to Governor in 1793, when the new federal constitution was adopted. In 1790, Dartmouth College conferred an honorary degree of Doctor of Medicine upon Bartlett. He also founded the New Hampshire Medical Society and was elected its first president. Bartlett's wife, Mary, died when he was 60, the year he was elected to the Senate. At age 65, he retired due to ill health, living only a year. Bartlett died the 19th of May, 1795, and was buried in Kingston, New Hampshire.